Everybody thought Season 6 was the end of the line for Modern Warfare and Warzone, but that looks like it's not the case, my friends. What's up, everybody? Chaos here, with new leaks and new information about Season 7 and how Black Ops Cold War is going to integrate with Warzone. We have a lot to talk about. Recent statements from Activision have given us more clarity on what's going on with Modern Warfare, Season 7, Warzone, Black Ops Cold War. We're going to go over everything. But before we do, I wanted to announce to you guys, I am now partnered with Apex Gaming PCs, and I have my own line of gaming PCs, the DEFCON line. If you guys need a budget-friendly PC, I've got you covered. If you want a mid-tier, we've got you covered. If you want to go maximum, we've got you covered with the DEFCON line. You guys, check it out. The link is at the top, the description. And if you want to get anything else from Apex, if you want to build your own PC, use code CHAOS. And please, please tweet at me. Let me know if you do. And if you see a DEFCON CHAOS PC you like, but you want to interchange a few hardware parts, you can do that. You can customize literally everything within that CHAOS case. The turnaround time right now is from order to shipping about 2 weeks. You guys, let me know if you pick one up. Now, let's get into this. Let's talk about why the potential for a Season 7 is becoming more and more likely in Warzone. Everybody knows, currently in Season 6, right? It began on September 29th, and generally speaking, seasons last about a month and a half to 2 months. This means that Season 6 should theoretically end in mid to late November. When does Black Ops Cold War launch? November 13th. You guys keep that in mind moving forward. A month ago, that would have made it look very easy that we could just assume Season 6 was it. Now, in a recent investors call, Activision revealed a ton about their plans for Black Ops Cold War. According to them, the game is going to launch on November 13th, but Season 1, the content season for Black Ops Cold War, will not start until December. This way, people will have a few weeks to get the new game, get situated with the mechanics and whatnot, and then the first season can officially get started. We will also have the next-gen consoles in our hand. Now, most season-based multiplayer games do it this way. I don't think it's a bad idea at all. Activision also said the Black Ops Cold War progression is going to be built upon the success of the Modern Warfare system, which it can be a little concerning when you think about it because Modern Warfare system didn't have a prestige mode, but we'll have to wait and see how that goes. I have a feeling we're going to be happy about that, but the fact that they're going along the system when it comes to the battle pass and everything like that is very, very good. Now, it's worth noting that once Warzone is integrated into Black Ops, the experience is going to be huge. All of your loadouts, all of your weapons, they are all going to carry over from the current version of Warzone into the new one. And this is going to be on top of all the new guns that are being added into the Black Ops Cold War player pool. There will be close to 100 guns available in custom classes in December, and that is going to be insane. The floor loot is still going to be Black Ops themed, but if you want to bring your Ram 7 or your R90 into that new experience, guess what? You have the option to do that. Now, it's unclear how the perks are going to work here, but I'm sure Treyarch and Infinity Ward were working pretty closely hand-in-hand to get it right. The most important part is, your weapons in progress in Modern Warfare Warzone are going to carry over into Black Ops Cold War. Also, this is something huge. It has been confirmed that you will be playing on the Modern Warfare Warzone engine. That's right, the engine that you're used to with Warzone, how it works, how everything looks, all just everything about how it plays, that is what you are going to be playing on. They are not going to be jumping or switching engines when it comes to Black Ops Cold War. And I know a lot of people were actually worried about that, myself included, because you just don't know how that's going to work. It could end up being months and months of just really bad stuff. But they have confirmed that we are going to be on the same engine, specifically for Warzone. So keep that in mind as we keep moving on. Now, let's talk about Season 7. Why do I think we're getting one? Well, let's take a look at this. Season 6 is set to end in a few weeks before the Black Ops integration for Warzone takes place. So what are they going to do in the meantime? Well, we know there are tons of game modes, weapons, and maps that have been leaked for Modern Warfare in the past that are not live. There is a lot of them. We also know that Infinity Ward and Activision want Modern Warfare to live on if they can help it. With that being said, Activision also doesn't want a big new Modern Warfare season to steal the spotlight from the Black Ops Cold War launch. So I think what we're looking at here is not going to be this huge Season 7 for Modern Warfare and Warzone, but rather just a new kind of stasis for the game to be in. Let me explain. Once Season 6 ends, there's probably going to be a huge update that brings the game to a normal state. And that will be the way it stays for the foreseeable future. Some could call that update a Season 7. I've already made a video or two about whether or not I think Modern Warfare will continue to be heavily supported after Black Ops is out, and that really remains to be seen. It really depends on how things go. After all, Black Ops 3 was supported long after its life cycle ended, but then something like Infinite Warfare, it was abandoned. It really was. Now, it just depends on how many people keep playing Modern Warfare after the new one comes out. I think Infinity Ward is planning on pushing out one final huge update that will put the game in its final state. Think of it like a final form, if you will. From that point on, it's just going to be a waiting game to see if more updates will be justified. So do I think we're going to officially get a Season 7 with the title Season 7? I don't know. I would, if I was betting, I would say probably not. But do I think we're going to get one big massive update that you could constitute as a Season 7? Very, very likely. Does that mean another battle pass? I don't know. I don't really know how they're going to do that. I know they don't want to steal the thunder from Black Ops Cold War, but they also don't want the game to die for a few weeks or a month or whatever until they're ready to integrate Warzone. That's a lot of money that would be lost in that short amount of time. So you guys, let me know what you think. This is everything we know up until this point. A lot of positives, a lot of good stuff. It's going to be interesting. The absolute customization in Warzone after December is going to be insane. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon. This month's giveaway is for your choice of a PS5 or an Xbox Series X. All you have to do to enter is drop a like, make sure you're subscribed, and leave a comment with your Twitter handle so we can get hold of you telling me which one you want. The winner is picked at the end of the month. Good luck.